Hey, good evening, and welcome to this documentary about the man, the myth, the legend, who has walked this earth for almost 50 years. Indeed, I am talking about Greg. So, sit back and relax and enjoy the journey. Hey, Greg, how's it going? You may be wondering why am I driving? For a good reason. Greg, we're going on a journey. A journey back to the very beginning, where everything started. Well, not everything. Quite honestly, Greg, I didn't really have the time or the desire to drive to where everything started because it's up in North St. Louis County, too far from where I live. And you're important to me, but I have a limit. So we're gonna go to the next best place where things started. At 69 McIntyre Drive in Fenton, Missouri. Come, let's go to where things started. Okay, Greg. We're almost to where everything kind of almost started, not exactly, but close enough, or at least as much as our budget will allow. And as we turn on to McIntyre Drive, here is your childhood home, 69 McIntyre Drive, Fenton, Missouri. Sorry, that noise is the blinker on the Jeep. How's it going?
Good.
Hey, my name's Tim Schulte. I actually grew up in this house. What's your name?
My name is Rick.
Rick, I have a question for you. I'm doing a project for my brother who turns 50 in a few weeks, and I'm putting together a little video, a documentary, if you will, about his life. Is it okay if I take a look around?
Absolutely.
All right.
I don't mind.
Awesome. Well, I will follow you. So,
I'm not sure exactly what you want to.
Well, I'd like
show
to
show him or kind of reminisce him, and I know I've been here for 25 years.
All right.
I like the house. I've been here, and I don't plan on moving.
Uh-huh.
I know there were some things neighbors told me about previous owners. I don't know if you were one of them or not.
It was probably a lot about my brother.
It could have been. I heard there was kind of a rambunctious younger man. There were two brothers and I believe a girl they had mentioned.
That would describe our family, yes.
Yeah, and they said that the younger boy was kind of rambunctious. Not to say he got in a lot of trouble, but sometimes it was just, for the lack of a better term, a pain in a lot of the neighbor's rear end. I don't know. I have never met him. It's nice to meet you, obviously. I'd like to learn a little bit more about the house myself. Maybe you can tell me some things.
Uh-huh.
I do have one thing. Were you guys involved in this garage in any way?
We spent the
bedroom you guys here.
Yeah. Let's see what the bedroom.
All right. This is
the bedroom.
It's now used as a guest bedroom.
Okay.
I have a trundle bed in it. Really just more for junk storage right now.
If I'm honest, that's what my brother used it for too.
You know, I came in, we saw some scribbling on the walls. I don't know if it was from that or not, from you guys playing tic-tac-toe or trying to do some design work on the walls. But anyway, it got covered up. It's not there no more, but obviously, if it was tic-tac-toe, someone was much better at it than the other. I think the score was like 10 to nothing. But anyway, it's pretty much just a storage room. The only thing really got changed is the window, new carpet, and fresh coat of paint.
Yeah, so that was fun being able to go and take a look at the house where
You know, at least for me, Greg, but between you and I, we shared that room together. I don't know if you remember exactly what that was like, sharing that space from the time we were toddlers or, you know, maybe 5 or 6 years old, you know, really until the time that that we graduated high school, that we shared that space. It was only about a 12 by 12 room, and we had the bunk beds, and I don't know if you remember the details or not, but you were quite a slob. I mean, actually, you were disgusting. And for many years, there was a line, literally a line in the middle of our room that indicated the clean zone, my zone, from the sloppy side, which was your side. I don't know what happened, but you're not a slob anymore. So, congratulations on that. Matter of fact, I'm looking around right now and the floors look amazing. Thank you for doing all the cleaning and prep work for the party before all of your guests arrive tonight. You know, so what I think we ought to do now is we need to go back a little bit, well, 50 years. And I want to share with all of those gathered here, your friends, your family, those that love you most, what you looked like when you came out of the womb. So, I mean, we could be really honest. You were a really good looking guy. I mean, when you were born, you were bald. You didn't have any teeth. You couldn't walk. And I mean, you've come a long way. I mean, you've got the Brillo pad up here now. You got all your teeth, and you walk pretty well. So to that, Greg, I just want to honor you. I mean, thumbs up on that hard work and this long journey that began 50 years ago. And you know, growing up together, I mean, you know, not only are we brothers, but I consider that we're really good friends too. And so here's a picture, again, going way back. We're probably just a few years old, and we're just hanging outside the brick wall. I mean, that's just what we did when we were kids. We just would go around and find these different brick walls and hang out and just look awesome doing it. That was an adorable picture. You know, but moving along, things went downhill pretty quickly. I mean, there is nothing more detestable than a man wearing whitey tidies. And for the love of God, Greg, why? Why did you wear those out in public? Okay, so that might have been a little disturbing. I hope you're not too embarrassed by that. I actually threw up in my mouth while I was watching that, but that's okay. I'm gonna shift gears a little bit, and I've put on the board here what I believe are some things that are represented by your name. And so the first G stands for gorgeous, because you are gorgeous. I mean, have you looked at yourself lately? You are amazing. And all, I'm your brother, but I actually have a man crush on you because you are so good looking. Oh, wait a second, someone's calling me. Hello? I'm in the middle of a broadcast here. I mean, I've got important work to do. I am doing a documentary on my brother's life, and I cannot believe, come on. There is no one by that name. What? Now, I've heard about you, and I've heard Greg and Barb talking about you, but I cannot. So why? Okay, so you're calling. You have something you want to say to Greg. Okay. Okay, so. All right, well, hey, hang on a second. This is a very high-tech operation here, so it'll just take a, a minute, a few taps on the button, and I will bring you up live feed on the screen right now. So we'll get back to this GREG thing. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Schulte, it's Baranowski. Happy 50th birthday. I don't know why you're not in Whitefish right now, because it's cold.
Hey, that's actually kind of cool to hear from him. I mean, I've seen pictures of him, videos. I know that you have talked to him. He holds you in very high regard. And it's what a wonderful surprise to hear from Bear live from Whitefish Mountain in Montana. So yeah, I forgot about the whole Greg thing, and you know, come on, it's Bear, so we got to recognize that. And you know, the next thing we're going to visit is, as we were growing up, we had we had this swing set in the backyard, and so the next picture is a picture of you on the swing. But you know, that swing set was the site of a life-changing event for you, Greg. And so let's take a look at that picture real quick, and then we'll go into the rest of the story. Love you, Bear. All right, well, that's a sweet picture. And I don't know, a lot of us have wondered for some time where you got the cranial crease, you know, that thing. Hey, Greg, let everyone look at your cranial crease here for a minute. Take a look. Look at the crease that he has, the cranial crease. Not genetic, but there's a story about how that came to be. Greg, you have a gift in front of you. I want you to open that gift. I'll give you a few seconds to do that. Come on, not rocket science. Yeah. You got it? Okay. Hold up what's inside the gift. That's right. It's a bloody hammer. And now to reveal where that crease came from. It's something that I'm deeply ashamed of. Because Greg, when you were younger, about the age of your former self on that swing, you must have did something, said something to really upset me. Because legend has it that I went into the house and grabbed a hammer. And I ran out into the backyard to the swing set. And quite honestly began going after you with this hammer. This is the actual hammer that was used perhaps 47 years ago to inflict what we now know as the cranial crease. And as I approached you, right? It was at that moment that our mother, Joyce, saw the event and what was about to happen. And she burst through the back door of the house. Her arm went through the glass. She had all these lacerations, and she ended up going to the emergency room. I got in trouble, and I think that's where the crease came from. So Greg, I know the crease is unique. It sets you apart from the rest of humankind, from the rest of us mere men. And so I'm coming clean, and this is a reminder the gift that I gave you as a child, the gift that we know as the cranial crease. So we're going to go fast forward. I'm sure there are other things that happened. We're going to fast forward to your high school years because those were a good time, weren't they, Greg? And there were several things that were popular in the 80s. Michael Jackson, Just Beat It. And Greg Schulte, Just Beating It. Not gonna lie, you made those drums look really good. And you were awesome at the drums. I'm not kidding, I mean, you were awesome at the drums. I don't know if we have any video of you ever playing the drums. There's probably some out there somewhere. But I can vouch that you were really good at beating those drums. And you rocked it, so thank you. Thank you for that. And of course, you know, who could forget all the wonderful times that we shared earning tons of money, like $3.10 an hour at minimum wage jobs to support our bad habits and our need for speed and our need for looking really good. I mean, really good. So now I present to you what two young men with combined earning potential of $6.20 per hour, what could be accomplished in 1984. We had good times in that car. Spent a lot of money on it, put a lot of gas in it, drove all over the place, raced in it. It was good times. It's really good times. And it was wonderful to share those experiences with you. And so moving on, I have two senior pictures. Greg, two senior pictures, but one of them is you, and one of them is someone else, but it's someone who I believe could be your stunt double, if you ever need a stunt double. So I'm going to present these two pictures, and I want you to consider which one is your senior picture. And which one belongs to someone else? Intriguing, isn't it? Intriguing. I'm going to run those pictures again in just a minute. But one of those pictures, Greg, is you, and the other one is Adam Sandler. Someone who I also honor and respect. And it's mainly because you both have Brillo pad hair. Obviously something that I don't have. I'm envious of your hair. So go forward a couple more years. Life is good, Greg. You begin your college career. And it's during your college career that you start, you know, getting things right. And you know, you quit all the loose living, wild parties, dressing up like a unicorn, talking horribly to law enforcement. And you meet the girl of your dreams who would eventually become your wife, mother of your four children. And matter of fact, the one who organized this fine event, this fine celebration of your 50th birthday, I present to you a picture of you and Barb early on in your relationship. Yeah, you're a good-looking couple then. You're still a good-looking couple. So good job on that. And of course, you know, this documentary, this recap of your 50 years wouldn't be complete if we didn't acknowledge the four wonderful children that you have. Allie and Abby, Jeff and John. So I want to share a picture. Your four lovely children. Yeah, Greg, let's be honest, man. You're blessed. You know, you got an awesome family, and you're the man. I mean, you're the man. You really are. You got the crease thing. Don't worry about that. You got the crease thing going on, but you're still the man. But you know, there was one area in your life that still needed work. And Greg, you were the owner of a garage queen. Let's be honest. You had a Rubicon, and for all those years, it sat in the garage. I went back and forth to the donut shop. Until recently, that is. Until recently, Greg. When you finally crossed the threshold from boyhood to manhood. And you took that garage queen out. Gave her what she wanted. Gave her rocks. And snow. And mud. And mountains. And you scaled mountains, Greg. And you're no longer a boy. You're a man. I honor you for that. And matter of fact, we need to get rid of this because it's not a garage queen anymore. Because you made her more than a garage queen. And you made yourself a man by doing it. Just take a look at some footage. Gibsby Gulch. You're killing it. You really are.
And as you bump up the passenger side, then cut it a little bit driver and come straight up. Yeah.
Gotta
get it.
Go. Just go straight. Go.
Go straight.
Go.
Just straight.
Go.
I mean, let's face it, man, you killed it. You killed it, man. You just went out and did what needed to be done. And you turned that garage queen into a woman of the trail because of your willingness to finally be a man. I honor you for that. Hang on a second. I got another call coming in. Hang on a second. Yeah, come. Man, I am busy. I'm doing this documentary for my brother. But I cannot understand what you're saying. Why do you talk that way? Oh, it's the way you were born. Okay, understood. So you have something you want to say to Greg? Okay, well, some other guy called the animal, spirit animal bear, called Greg. So, okay, well, I will allow it. We're almost out of time, so let me put you on hold. I've got to press a button on my smartphone, and then you should be live here. I'm going to count down. You ready? 3, 2, 1.
Hey, Greg. Happy 50th birthday here from Whitefish. Hopefully you can see the lake behind us. Beautiful day. Bit of clouds will be all the better if you were up here, my friend. Anyway, we'll see you up here soon with the families again. Look forward to seeing you over the weekend, and you have a wonderful 50th birthday. Take care, Greg. Bye.
All right, brother. So I hope you've enjoyed this journey, this documentary that touched a couple of important areas of your life and your formative years and some things that have happened over the years that have made you the fine man, the wonderful husband, loving father, and the awesome brother that you are. And I hope this documentary has been meaningful to you. I hope it's answered some questions that you were seeking answers about. And Greg, I mean this in all sincerity. I love you, man. You're my brother. You're my friend. And I love you. And we're going to close this time together. I'm going to fade away and just take in a few more pictures. Video's not over. False alarm. This is truly the last thing. Greg, there's something that I want to give you some freedom. I want to give you freedom tonight. You're going to receive freedom from something that's been holding you in bondage for most of your adult life. I don't know why. I know that you have an aversion to male nipples and seeing them. You don't like to display yours, and I understand that you've got that weird third nipple thing going on. I don't know where that came from. I mean, I will take full credit for the cranial crease, but the third nipple thing, I don't know, and maybe that's part of it. But Greg, I'd be remiss if I didn't give you the ultimate birthday present right now. You can look at them, enjoy, embrace them, and I give you freedom. I give you freedom tonight on your 50th birthday. To display all three of your nipples, loud and proud. Let the world see how beautiful you are. It's true, you're free now. You're free. Embrace.